Hello, welcome to the fantastic demo experiment of Bernoulli principle. This is a very special machine called as air blower. This air blower has a very powerful motor, and this motor has very high RPM. RPM means rotations per minute. This has got 16,000 RPM. 16,000 is quite large RPM, and the moment we switch on this motor, we can hear a peculiar sound which is showing the power of the motor and RPM. When I put my hand over this flow, you can feel the pressure of air on my fingers. If I have guessed that what is the distribution of pressure or velocity, some graph against the x dimension perpendicular to the vertical axis, I will get the graph like this. This graph means there is a peak in the center and tapering down on both sides, sloping down. But if I attach a pipe here and then I feel what is the pressure distribution, I will get a totally different distribution. You can see it now. Now if I guess what is the distribution, I will get the graph like this. The graph is very tall, large height, very sharp peak, and the spread is less because of this pipe. This pipe will make the air blow focus in one direction. And over this air blow, if I keep a ball, see what happens. Now when the ball is floating, if I make the airflow cut, you will always feel that the ball will fall down, but it doesn't fall. You can see this. When this ball is floating in air, we can ask the question why the ball does not fly away this way or that way or any direction. Bernoulli explained this phenomenon, and why the ball keeps on floating is based on Bernoulli principle, scientific principle. The principle says that when the ball is floating in air, its pressure, its weight is balanced by the vertical force applied by the air. So the air applies vertical force to balance the weight of the ball. But if the ball tries to go on this side, suppose it shifts on one side, either this or this ball, you can say this ball shifts on this side, the air going here is at high speed and the air going in this direction is low speed. So Bernoulli made one postulate, assumption, that where there is high speed, there is less pressure, and where there is less speed, there is more pressure. So what happens? Surrounding air from this surrounding air will push the ball towards this direction because the pressure here is more and the pressure here is less. It is less because its velocity of the air is more here. Now if the ball tries to go on this side, then what will happen? Air here is high speed and here is low speed. So the air will push the ball in this direction. So wherever the ball will try to go, the surrounding air will always keep on pushing the ball towards the central maxima line. Now, difficult concept, central maxima line. How you understand central maxima line? Imagine the axis of this pipe. And on the axis of the pipe, the velocity of the air coming out is maximum. And that is the line where a ball can achieve equilibrium. So this equilibrium is very important phenomenon. And here, we can see one more interesting thing. that if the ball is floating here, now suppose the ball is floating here, and if I make this pipe tilted, if I make the angle change, you can find that the ball which is floating here will come here. But many people think that when the ball will come here, it will fall down because the force is in this direction and weight is in this direction. But it is not true. See what happens actually. It appears like magic that I have taken the ball from here to this position and I have pulled it back without thread applied to it and the ball will come back here. This is because of this flow which is coming out from this pipe will keep the ball captured in the flow. So keeping the ball captured in the flow is because of Bernoulli principle. That is very interesting. Now further interesting is that if I make this angle more and more and more, you can imagine that after some angle, the ball will fall because Bernoulli pressure has limitation. And if you cross that limit, the ball will fall. You can see this. So there is some critical angle and if you go beyond that critical angle, the ball will fall. And if you rotate this critical angle in all directions, you can imagine a cone. And in that cone, the ball has equilibrium. And if you go beyond a cone, it cannot remain in equilibrium. That is what is interesting feature. Now further interesting feature is, if I keep the ball floating here and suppose I play a mischief, I switch off the motor when the ball is floating here. What will happen? Many people say the ball will either fly in that direction or the ball will fall vertically downwards or the ball will fall in this direction. It is difficult to guess what will happen. And many people say the ball will fall vertically downward. But it is wrong answer. You can see what happens actually. It is damn interesting that the ball came down this way. And why the ball come down this way is because of the flow keep the ball captured in the flow. So the flow will keep the ball trapped in this direction. That is central maxima line. It is a very interesting experiment because many people ask this question that how you explain the equilibrium of a ball here. Why the ball remains in equilibrium here? The reason is like this. Suppose the ball is here, its mass is m, so its weight is mg. Now this mg has two components. One is mg sine theta towards this pipe and mg cos theta perpendicular. This mg sine theta is balanced by this air pressure and mg cos theta is balanced by the Bernoulli pressure. So Bernoulli pressure is balancing mg cos theta. And that is why the ball behaves as if it is on the inclined plane. And when I switch off, it will fall down the plane that you have seen just now. So it is very interesting that the ball always remains trapped in the airflow. It is our Bernoulli principle. Thank you.